saved people sit in their pews.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
You don't have to come to the altar. But I love the altar.
Yes.
I believe you can be sanctified, filled with the Holy Ghost, sitting down. That's exactly what they was doing on the day of Pentecost. The Bible said, clothed in tongues as fire. Not fire, but as fire. And clothed in tongues, divided, set upon each of them right where they were sitting. Right where they were sitting. Now, when you find you an altar beside your bed, down where we live in the orange grove, or behind the cemetery. And the other day, the wife and I, we go to the cemetery and Bill quite a bit. But I was walking, it's a big cemetery, walking and praying for a long time before we ever got here that God will send revival, amen, to the Lesslie Church of God. Amen. Send a move of God. Amen. One that'll last until Jesus comes.
Amen.
Glory to God. I got the feeling of the Holy Ghost amongst the dead. I was walking by myself. Cameron went and my wife, but they was on the other end of the cemetery. But I had my hands up and praising God and praying. Amen. And I felt so something hit me way down deep inside. Glory to God. And I want to tell you something. Amen. The same Holy Ghost that hit me in that graveyard, even though I was amongst the dead. But I've been in a lot of church of God that's just as neat. But anyway, God moved. And I'm here to tell you, God can move this Monday night.
Yes.
Sit right there on your pew. If you'll get good and clean, there ain't enough devils in hell can keep the Holy Ghost out.
Yes.
And that's what everybody needs. No matter how young you are, how old you are, you need to be filled with the baptism of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Hallelujah. All right, notice that this verse is in 52, the last verse of the 13th chapter of the book of Acts. Now, this is after the great outpouring, and then it's after the church were beaten, ridiculed like never before, imprisoned, just their backs laid open, but yet this verse says, and the disciples were filled with joy and with the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
I was reading that not long ago, and I read it a many times since I've been saved. Amen. But the Holy Ghost gave me something brand new. Amen. No devil or anybody, your trials and your tribulations can beat the Holy Ghost out of you. Glory to God. And Jesus said, no man can take your joy.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
It's very important that we Church of God people, amen, have joy.
Yes. Amen.
Right.
Hallelujah. Joy unspeakable and full of glory. Church, we need it.
Yes.
Amen. The world is facing things that people of nowadays have never faced before. We're living in perilous times. We're living in evil times. You can just pull out in front of somebody and get shot.
Amen.
Cursed out or beat up. I'm telling you, we need the protection of the Holy Ghost. And people nowadays is walking around in the mall, on the street, on the job, everywhere with a long countenance. And I'm afraid that the church is joining them. One thing we have seen in our travels is a great falling away, not in attendance.
Right.
There's a lot of churches. Amen. Our home church in Lakeland, Florida, our district church runs, I think, around about 900 to 1,000. And other churches around there, huge churches, Pentecostal churches, Assemblies of God, Churches of God. You go there on Sunday mornings, and the churches and the balconies are packed. It's not a falling away of people. It's a falling away of the Spirit of God. And one thing, I look around, I preached in the church not long ago. Amen. Our district church. Amen. And it's the joy of the Lord. keep the joy of God. Don't lose your joy. I'm telling you, it is strength. It is strength. Amen. I'm going to say it again. The joy of the Lord is our strength. Glory to God. But I'm telling you, church, if people will just get their joy back, I believe the church will start filling up again. I'm talking about holiness churches.
Come on now.
We've been to a lot of independent holiness camp meetings and things, churches. And it seems like they'll get in the choir and they'll sing, everybody's going to be happy over there. And looks like they've been baptized in vinegar.
Right.
You know, it's a shame for people to get in the choir and have no joy and sing about heaven's jubilee. Because the sinners are sitting back. The unspiritual are sitting back and saying, is that all it is to it?
Right.
People have a better time at the skating rink. They have a better time at the honky-tonks, the dance halls. Come on now. Brother, I'm telling you, the house of God, amen, we need the joy of the Lord, not just in the house of God, but on our jobs, in our schools. Amen, I'm telling you, we need to be so filled with joy. People to ask, amen, what are you on? And then you can tell them, amen, you're saved. Hallelujah. I tell you what, amen, the disciples came back. Jesus sent them out by twos, and then when the 70 returned, they were rejoicing. Amen, that the devils were subject unto his name. But Jesus said, don't be happy because your name, are they subject unto my name, but be happy because your name is written down in the Lamb's book of life. I'm happy because I'm saved. Glory to God. Here we go, let me get caught.
Blessing Jesus.
Blessing
Jesus. Amen. Wear that, son. Oh, Lord. Ooh, now I feel like I feel free. Hallelujah. I want to tell you a story, a true story. This man was raised and saw his parents grow old, gray-headed, and never been to church. Can you imagine being raised in a house where your mother never known salvation, never been saved. Daddy was never saved. Their hair had turned gray. But he decided one day to go to town. And there was a tent meeting. And he slipped in. He'd never been to church. And he slipped in on the back. And he's looking around. And he heard them singing. And he said they was happy. He'd seen smiles on their face and looking around and everybody was happy. And he didn't know nothing like that. He never experienced nothing like that. And he heard some woman praying, God, send the rain. Send the rain. Send the rain. And then he heard somebody else say, God, send the fire. Send the fire. Send the fire. He thought to himself, what did they want? Well, fire and then rain to put the fire out. What did they want? He didn't know nothing. You know, we got people right here around us that have never been in the house of God, never experienced salvation. Amen. But he couldn't get over the one thing, amen, he saw that he didn't have, or his mother or father didn't have, and that was some joy.
Yeah.
Amen. He said, after a while, sitting there for a long time, he said, that's what I want. He said, I want what they got. Whatever it is, that's what I want. Church, I'm telling you, we'll get some joy. Amen. People on the job might want what you want. God. Amen. I worked in the phosphate mines, and when I got saved, it was dust. I worked on the dusty side, and then I worked on the dry side where they make sulfuric acid. But anyway, it was dry. But everybody on the job was dry. There was a Baptist, and I'm not running the Baptist down. I know a lot of Baptists. My grandmother was holiness Baptist. But anyway, I know some Baptists that are saved, and some have got the Holy Ghost. But this was a Baptist Sunday school teacher. And I walked into the break room. And he was telling one of the filthiest jokes I ever heard. Come, you know, the Bible said don't let no filthy communication proceed out of your mouth. Now, I'm telling you the truth. I was at a business one time where this Church of God man, he was kind of wealthy. But anyway, I heard some, he got mad at his son-in-law and even went to swinging at him and cursing him. And then Sunday morning, he was in church. And I heard some filthy talk come out of his mouth. I've been around some church people where they went, I didn't mean to say that. And I said, yes, you did to myself. Oh, yes, you did. But the Bible said, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaking. But, bro, when you get good salvation, all those four-letter words go. Come on now. It don't make no difference. You break your toe, break your leg or arm, even nothing will come out. If it ain't in there, it won't come out. Can you say amen? But I'm here to tell you, praise the Lord, hallelujah. Ain't this a beautiful day, even though it's raining? If I am a person that's saved.
Right.
Amen. Amen. But anyway, he said when the invitation was given, he said, the preacher said that I could be born again. So he went down and he prayed. And they prayed. He prayed through. And when he got home, amen, he slipped in around the midnight hour. And his mother and father heard him when he come in. And night after night, they heard him when they come in, but every morning, Colonel, he was smiling at them. Mom and Daddy wasn't smiling like a lot of people in the choir. But he said he couldn't help it. It was just coming. Have you ever had somebody say, I love you? And you can feel it, don't you?
That
little smake smile. Have you ever heard people talking on the telephone? As soon as it's over.
Yeah.
You know it was fake.
Right.
But I'm telling you, when God saves your soul, you won't have to fake it. A preacher came down in our way one time. He said, fake it till you make it. I said, no, you don't have to fake it. I'm here to tell you it can be real. Real salvation. I put a smile on your face.
Yeah.
Glory to God. It put joy in you and you'll just glow. Your countenance will glow. Anyway, every morning he was smiling at mom and dad. Finally, his dad said, boy, where you been going every night? He said, church. He said, what kind of church lasts around midnight or after? He said, I don't know the name of it, but you're going to a tent meeting. Night after night. And he said he worked hard all day on the farm. And he'd come in, he'd get ready, and go to church night after night, night after night. Amen. You know, if you want something from God, you need to go to church.
Amen.
Every time the doors is open, you need to be here. Can you say amen? Well, glory to God. Anyway, he said he come in one evening, and he got ready for church. And Brother Bogan, he said his mama come out of the bedroom all dressed up with her pocketbook. Daddy come in the back door, said, woman, where you think you going? She said, I'm going down to church where Jack's been going. Oh, brother, I'm telling you, your lost loved ones can't stand it. He said he never had witnessed. He never told them about the plan of salvation. He never told them nothing. All he can do every morning is smile. I'm telling you, we can win more people, amen, with the joy of the Lord than we can ramming the scriptures down their throat. Amen. Hallelujah. He said when the invitation was given. Hallelujah. He said one of the greatest sights he ever saw in his life was his little old gray-headed mama heading down that altar.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. He said even back in those days, he said when a carnival would come to town or some event would come to town, the store would stay open late. He said, mama said, Jack, we need a few things. This is after church, after she got saved. She said, we need to stop at the store, and I need to pick up a few things. And back in those days, they used to have canned goods out in the aisle, you know, in a circle. And I remember 10 cans of tomatoes or something like that for $1. Now they're $1, $2 a can. But anyway, she went to reach to get a can of tomatoes, and that big old red tomatoes, the preacher preached on the blood of Jesus that night. It reminded her of what he preached on and what God did for her, saved her. He said right there in the store, Mama never knew nothing about being saved, never went to Baptist church or Methodist church or nothing. He said right there, my little old gray-headed mama, and then she let out a scream and went, "Woo! Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus." And went to, "Woo! Glory to God. I feel the Holy Ghost here again tonight." I'm telling you, we ought not to hide it. We need to put our light on the hillside. Amen. Don't put it under a bushel, but let it shine. Yes. This little